Every year, 100,000 Nigerian infants die of a genetic disease called sickle cell disorder. A challenge in researching genetic cures is the high dimensionality of the data, which requires the processing power of a supercomputer. Now, these computers are not readily available in less developed countries, like Nigeria, my home country, making critical genetic research impossible. A simpler example of this type of research is what gene causes colorblindness. To answer this question, we collect data about all the genes in a human to identify the gene that causes colorblindness. However, humans have about 20,000 genes. So if I have a sample of 2,000 people, the number of variables, that is the number of genes, will be larger than the sample size. This is called high-dimensional data. One problem with analyzing high-dimensional data is that you get unreliable results when all of the available data set is used at once for analysis. So to solve this problem, you typically split the data randomly into two so that analysis is done on each separate set to assess the effect of interest. Randomly splitting the data does not consider the inherent structure of the data set. Imagine a pie. Cutting it into two halves represents a random split, which distorts the circular structure. To compensate for this distortion, randomly splitting the data 1,000 times is practiced. However, this is computationally inefficient as it takes a lot of processing power and memory. So what if we can strategically split the data fewer number of times and still get the desired result? My proposed method with a standard computer uses the structure of the data for splitting, which achieves computational efficiency and gives reliable result. Picture a donut. Instead of cutting it into two halves, you cut out a donut hole, which maintains the same round shape. But why do we need the same round shape? Having the same round shape ensures that data points that share similar statistical properties are grouped together. By grouping similar structures together, each separate set possesses the same characteristics as the whole. Splitting the data set twice with my proposed method takes less memory, is 10 times faster, and achieves the same desired result. These advantages will make analysis of high-dimensional data accessible to all researchers all over the world. I hope that my method will inspire researchers in Nigeria to develop genetic treatment, reducing the devastating effect of sickle cell disorder. Thank you.